Did you guys make an intentional effort to sound different than Sound of Color, being that that was a band record and this is a solo record?
I mean, I feel like we just try to sound kind of like the demos, like the idea of the demos.
Yeah.
And try to do that.
I mean, her demos, the first time she played them for me, they kind of blew my mind. But she'd picked out all these, like even when you everything you had kind of done in the demo was kind of like a jumping off point for the record. So I was just trying to think of, like, even if you used like a sample or something in the demo,
yeah,
it was like, oh, well, what thing in reality sounds like that? So how can we do that? There wasn't a lot of talk about how it related to Sound of Color.
Yeah, not at all, really. Yeah,
never. I mean, the only thing that I felt about Sound of Color was like, people seemed to like the sound of it, so I felt like I needed to like make sure that this sounded as good or better. So that was my only like concern, was that it was like, I was really like being hard on myself about the way it sounded.
Yeah, I mean, we tried some crazy stuff, getting some sounds. I can't explain what happened, but Shawn can explain what happened, yeah, with like some sort of pen that captures electromagnetic waves. And then also doing, what do you call the tape loop thing? What do you call that?
Just like a tape loop, basically. We were just trying crazy stuff.
I can't speak on it. I didn't know what was going on.
Yeah.
At one point I was playing like a mixing board. I was playing the faders as notes, as a keyboard. So here comes the A, and you're making chords with your hands, and you're trying to, it's like an analog tape loop.
I found this company. It's not a company. It's like one guy who makes like contact mics, which is just microphones that press against things and pick them up, as opposed to going through the air. He makes this special contact microphone. It's not even a contact microphone. It's like almost like a laser that you just have to really crank, and it picks up electromagnetic interference. And so we were picking up
there was an air conditioning unit
in the studio that we were just moving it around the room because it picked up different electromagnetic interference. And then we found a place where it really like hit, where it was the air conditioning unit, and it had this crazy electromagnetic frequency, and it sounded really cool. So then we put it on a piece of tape that was looping around the studio. And then we would speed up and slow down the tape machine to get different pitches from the electromagnetic interference from the air conditioning unit. So then we generated basically a synthesizer on a tape loop.
On a mixing board.
From speeding up and slowing down the tape machine. Yeah. And then we put all of that together and then put it on to a tape machine so that she could play it as like a synth.
And then I don't think we even used it.
No, we didn't use it.
But it was cool, though.
It was fun.
It was very cool.